So in the IES practice guide on RTI, the fifth and final recommendation refers to what to do in Tier 3. Provide intensive instruction daily that promotes the development of various components of reading proficiency to students who show minimal progress after reasonable time in Tier 2 small group instruction. This recommendation includes focusing on a small number of high priority skills in a one-on-one or small group setting. So regular progress monitoring can demonstrate whether the program is working for the students or whether changes need to be made. It recommends practices to carry out this recommendation, and these are to implement concentrated instruction that is focused on a small but targeted set of reading skills, adjust the overall lesson pace, schedule multiple and extended instructional sessions daily, include opportunities for extensive practice and high-quality feedback with one-on-one instruction. Plan and individualize Tier 3 instruction using input from a school-based RTI team. So again, here we are with the importance of that team. And ensure that Tier 3 students master a reading skill or strategy before moving on. When is a special education referral appropriate? If an English learner does not make progress typical of true peers and has been through a minimum of 2 rounds of Tier 3 intervention with fidelity, then it's advisable to have the student assessed for the existence of any exceptionality. It's important to note, however, that federal and state guidance has reiterated that RTI or SRBI may not be used to delay or deny timely initial evaluations for students suspected of having a disability. A referral received at any time, regardless of the tier of intervention a child may be receiving, must be reviewed by a planning and placement team. So, Tier 3 interventions incorporate intensive and research-based small group instruction, additional time each day during, before, or after school, progress monitoring every week with instruction adjusted based on findings, all education personnel working together to assist the child, parents involved and provided with data about their child's performance, and assistance that may be both in the general classroom and in pull-out classrooms, which is similar to what someone had suggested earlier in one of our chat boxes. So the Capel publication on SRBI suggests that when implementing Tier 3 interventions with students who are English learners, teachers should take into account a few considerations in terms of what interventions should look like for all students versus those who are English learners. So first, when Tier 3 interventions are conducted with non-English learners, they are short-term, 8 to 20 weeks, and are well-matched to students' specific academic, social, behavioral needs. They are also more intensive and individualized than Tier 2 interventions. With English learners, interventions may include modified curriculum from Tiers 1 and 2 because students need additional language supports necessary for accessing core content. So therefore, curriculum instruction must be further adapted to address English learners' specific language and content learning needs. So as we discussed earlier in terms of what Tier 3 interventions might look like with all students versus English learners, non-English learners' Tier 3 instruction would be delivered to homogeneous groups, so students with similar needs, with a teacher-to-student ratio of up to 1 to 3, and would be developed based on the Common Core State standards. For English learners, it may not be possible to deliver instruction to homogeneous groups. And student-to-teacher ratios may vary depending on the English learners in a class or school, their backgrounds, and available instructional expertise. So when working with English learners, teachers should be sure to carefully and frequently monitor students' progress. And although content will, of course, also be based on Common Core State standards, it may also include new and different resources that account for students' language learning needs, as well as other language proficiency related standards. So again, drawing from the IES practice guide, Tier 3 interventions might involve provision of scaffolded instruction that includes frequent opportunities for students to practice and review newly learned skills and concepts in a range of contexts to promote retention. So to scaffold instruction, activities should be broken down into smaller, manageable units. Someone talked about this again also earlier in our chat, this notion of chunking. Rather than giving all of the instruction for the activity, begin with the description, then teachers might check for comprehension, and then continue the description. So we might be then breaking a task down into smaller parts when teaching complex tasks, such as listening comprehension and text-based comprehension. So teaching should also be explicit and systematic with ample modeling and think alouds. English learners will benefit from structured instructions because they will recognize the various aspects that come in sequence. So we show students clearly how to perform a particular task and go over the steps with them, making sure that the thinking processes are overt and visible. So also, teachers in Tier 3 should be exceptionally careful to frequently check for understanding and integrate numerous diverse scaffolding strategies. So a Tier 3 intervention might also involve, given that English learners are more likely to have an incomplete understanding of instructions, paraphrasing complex instructions in a text to help everyone understand.